Let's go back to Gus live at Fletcher Allen in Burlington tonight. Hi there, Gus.
Well, Stephanie, it's one of the key ways to protect yourself. Chances are you do it at least several times a day, and chances are you're not doing it the right way. We're talking about hand washing. Think you're getting all the germs off your hands? Experts here at Fletcher Allen say, think again.
When Fletcher Allen nurse Rick Lamb scrubs up for surgery, it's serious business. Working up a lather, scrubbing with iodine-based soap. From fingertips to elbows, it takes at least 5 minutes to be OR ready.
How often should you be washing your hands? Because we're hearing all the time, wash, wash, wash.
I don't really think there's a real good answer to that. Mm-hmm. It's more of a common sense.
But for an everyday hand wash, there are some guidelines, and it starts with the suds. Rick says use an antimicrobial hand soap.
It's really how you use those soaps that's important. We'll just push it in and get about a quarter size of the soap in your hand.
Quarter size.
And then just start lathering it up and making sure you're covering all the surface of your hands. Just kind of do that. And that way you'll get some under your nails and your cuticles. And also in between your fingers. A lot of people don't get in between the fingers.
Between there.
Yeah. So you should do anywhere from a 10 to 15 second good sudsy hand wash under warm water.
Okay.
And don't make a common mistake after you've done everything right.
What do you do when you see those faucets?
Take another couple towels. Put them on the faucet.
So don't touch those faucets after you've washed your hands.
Exactly.
And it is not just the faucets. The bathroom knob is just as disgusting as you think it is. Now, I found these in our newsroom. They're probably all over where you work. We're talking about hand sanitizer here versus hand soap. Here's the thing with sanitizer. Doctors say it kills germs, but it does not get rid of dirt. You got to use soap for that. So in essence, you got to use both. Can't substitute one for the other. All right, so you've got hand soap, you've got hand sanitizer, just some of the things that'll keep you healthy. But what happens when you get sick? Doctors don't want you going to the store and infecting other people. That's why they want people, while they're healthy, to set up something called a flu kit. We're going to tell you about that now. It's something that you keep around. You have medicine, for example, fever-reducing medicine like Tylenol, cold or cough medicine, since H1N1, remember, is a respiratory illness. You should also have liquids such as Gatorade that has electrolytes and ginger ale and always helps with an upset stomach, at least it does for me. And it's important, of course, to eat. You can't go food shopping if you're sick, or at least you don't want to. Best things to have in the pantry, soup and saltine crackers.